Good morning. To the presidents of the local host chapters, the 27th Southeastern Regional Director, Dr. Tracy Morant Adams, the 26th Southeastern Regional Director, Attorney Mitzi Deese Page, the 23rd Southeastern Director, Juanita Sims Doty, all former chapter presidents, all who serve Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, and all of our guests, good morning again. My name is Sharon Williams, and I am the president of Beta Delta Omega Chapter. And we are so happy and elated to join with our sister chapters for this 115th day celebration. Our founders created a vision with Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority that will last perpetually by serving all mankind. We have a rich history of being the first in many areas and paving the way for others. We have blazed trails, carried torches all across the world by making significant impacts in the areas of education, STEM, entrepreneurship, the arts, political affairs, and yes, even into space. In 1934, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority planted her feet here in Mississippi by chartering the first graduate chapter, Beta Delta Omega Chapter, where we have continued the legacy that our founders created. Our 364 members are soaring to greater heights of service and sisterhood with our international initiatives. Locally, we have partnered with the Bethlehem Center, Habitat for Humanity, and the American Heart Association to reach people where they are in the communities. So we are so glad you have joined us today, and we hope that you enjoy today's program. Again, you're welcome.
To our local chapter presidents, the Southeastern Regional Director, and guests, good morning. I am Dr. Chelsea Criddle, President of the Rolando Omega Chapter, located here in Jackson, Mississippi. Chartered on October 23, 1988, by 32 remarkable women, guided by traditions and devoted to service and sisterhood, our membership has grown into a force of 185 phenomenal and civic-minded women, ready to galvanize our community and to be supreme in service to all mankind. Rolando Omega Chapter has a rich history of successfully expanding our footprints by implementing community service projects which fulfill tangible needs and make a difference in the lives of individuals residing in the Jackson metropolitan area. This year, we will celebrate our enduring legacy and trailblazing contributions to the community during our 35th anniversary. I would like to welcome you to our joint Founders Day program as we celebrate Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated for 115 years of service. This morning, you will be in for a memorable experience as members of our beloved sorority have come together to commemorate this Founders Day, built on the foundation of service, legacy, and sisterhood. Individually, we bring our unique talents and skills to this illustrious organization, but collectively, we are stronger when united in service and sisterhood. Rolando Omega Chapter extends our expression of gratitude to our Southeastern Regional Director, Dr. Tracy Morant Adams, for your willingness to serve as our keynote speaker. Your leadership is supreme, and we are elated and honored to soar with power throughout the Southeastern region. We would also like to extend our deepest gratitude to the steering committee and members of each chapter who work tirelessly to make this day a success. Today, we celebrate the leadership, commitment, and insight of our visionary founders on whose shoulders we stand. Since 1908, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated has continued to thrive in implementing programs, developing partnerships, and providing exceptional service within local communities throughout the world. I would like to extend heartfelt thanks to each of you for celebrating with us this morning. Welcome, and we hope that you enjoy the program. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Turquita Martin. I am president of Upsilon Upsilon Omega in Canton, Mississippi. To the local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guest, I bring to you greetings as we celebrate 115 years of sisterhood and service. Today, as we commemorate the humble beginnings of our sorority, we cannot forget that on January 15, 1908, in Minor Hall on the campus of Howard University, the brilliant and courageous women who brought to fruition their vision of sisterhood and commitment to servant leadership with the birth of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. These young women, just one generation out of slavery, envisioned the world where everyone had equal access to housing, food, health care, and education. These courageous women came together and embraced a common call to be of service to all mankind. On behalf of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Upsilon Upsilon Omega Chapter, I extend a heartfelt welcome to the 2023 Metro Jackson Area Founders Day celebration. As current president of Upsilon Upsilon Omega, I would like to take a personal point of privilege and acknowledge that on January 24th, we celebrated 25 years of service. With a current membership of over 130 talented, dedicated, and diverse women, we are very proud of our legacy of leadership, sisterhood, and supreme service to the Madison and Lee County areas. For 25 years, the women of Upsilon Upsilon Omega have been at the forefront of civic and humanitarian efforts in our local communities. I believe our dear founders would be immensely proud of our service and program impact. While we have served countless numbers of people, our work is far from done. We will continue to soar and advocate for social change in our areas that we serve. We are delighted that you are here with us today to share this special occasion. Again, on behalf of Upsilon Upsilon Omega, welcome and enjoy.
Greetings to local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guest. I am Gloria Jameson, president of the Omega Beta Omega Chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, chartered in May 16, 2015 in Yazoo City, Mississippi, the gateway to the Delta. Omega Beta Omega is home to 26 actively engaged ladies who believe through service and sisterhood, we can offer better opportunities to the Lower Delta communities of Humphreys and Yazoo County. This Founders Day, we commemorate the actions of our founders and celebrate the impact of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority's commitment to mankind. In paraphrase of the words of Muhammad Ali, service is the rent we pay here for our sojourn on this earth. Service to all mankind is what helps define our sisterhood. And through our commitment to uplift, assist, and to hold one another accountable, we each shall begin our ascent into the skies where only the eagles dare to soar. As we begin this Founders Day program, I ask each of you to begin envisioning the heights we may mount as we work cohesively as service providers. On behalf of Omega Beta Omega Chapter, I encourage you to allow today's program to refuel your service engine, preserve our sorority's legacy. Thus, I extend a heartfelt welcome to each of you as we celebrate 115 years of service and sisterhood and soar to another season of service. Thank you.
Well, that's a tough act to follow, Sorgor. So, next, we will have a selection from our Founders Day Choir, directed by April Majors and Sandra Kelly. followed by greetings from my undergraduate presidents and vice president. And also, you will hear of their occasion.
Thank you.
local chapter presidents, Southeastern Regional Director, and guests. Greetings. I am Allison McGowan, First Vice President of the Gamma Omicron Chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated at Tougaloo College. I am honored to greet all of you on behalf of our chapter in the absence of our president. For over 115 years, Alpha Kappa Alpha has stayed true to its mission and its motto. What began on the campus of Howard University on January 15, 1908, has spread to colleges, universities, and communities across the globe. Alpha Kappa Alpha remains devoted to soaring to greater heights in sisterhood and in service. Today, we pause to take a moment to pay homage to our great founders and their dedication to scholarship, service, and sisterhood. As we all reflect and remember the legacy of service to all mankind that has been deeply rooted since 1908, it is our sincere desire that each of you continue to perpetuate the dedication to our dear Alpha Kappa Alpha and continue to make the supreme in service. On behalf of the members of Gamma Omicron, we greet each of you. Thank you and continue to stay safe and well. To the local guests, Madam Regional Director, and Presidents, good morning. My name is Felicia Sheriff, and I proudly serve as the President of the Gamma Rho Chapter at Jackson State University. On behalf of the members of the glamorous Gamma Rho Chapter, I bring you greetings and humble salutations. The ladies of Gamma Rho are elated and grateful to be here to celebrate 115 years of scholarship, sisterhood, and service. We would also like to give a special acknowledgement to our Madam Regional Director, Dr. Tracy Morant Adams, for traveling to be with here today. The ladies of Gamma Rho hope your time in Jackson is soulful, impactful, and most importantly, glamorous. Thank you and welcome, welcome, welcome.
Greetings to the local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guests. Good morning. I am Asia Johnson, president of the Lambda Iota Chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. And it is my honor and sincere pleasure to welcome you to our Founders Day celebration. Today, we pause to pay tribute and celebrate the rich legacy of our beloved founders, whose mission was to cultivate and encourage high scholastic and ethical standards, to promote unity and friendship among college women, to study and help alleviate problems concerning girls and women, to maintain a progressive interest in college life, and to be of service to all mankind. 115 years later, we all continue to soar to greater heights as we all strive and do to fulfill this mission through sisterhood and service. Thank you and welcome.
If I could sing like Patti LaBelle, I would sing you a love song today. If I could write like Maya Angelou, my poetry would have it going on. If I could dance like MC Hammer, it would be hammer time tonight. And if I could play like Michael Jordan, averaging 30 points a game would be my plight. If I could act like Denzel Washington, I would be in Hollywood. And if I could talk like Martin Luther King, there would be no doubt where I stood. But I don't sing like Patty. And I don't write, I'm sorry, and I don't write like Maya, my dear. I don't dance like MC Hammer, and I certainly won't try it here. I don't play like Mike or act like Denzel, nor do I speak like Martin or have a story to tell. But what I am an Alpha Kappa Alpha woman with a duty at hand, and here to tell you and those all over the land, Alpha Kappa Alpha women, we have a duty to soar and a duty to give more, a duty to build and a duty to fulfill, a duty to serve and a duty to conserve, a duty to lead and a duty to realize need, a duty to sisterhood never meant to be misunderstood, a duty to community because it is a necessity. A duty to soar because the need is more. To the host chapter presidents, the Southeastern Regional Director, and guests, my name is Cherie Jones of Rolemda Omega Chapter, and this splendid occasion is to pay homage to our astute and perceptive founders and the members who understood the essentiality of continuity and perpetuity. This opportune occasion is to celebrate our 115 years of service to all mankind. This aromatic occasion is a mechanism to bring light to the issues that impact our families and our communities. This relevant occasion commemorates our past. It appreciates our present and it transcends our future. The women of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated will take heed to the call of duty. We will not accept a mission impossible. People will know it's a different world because of who we are and what we stand for. Because of our duty to unity and community, there will be no such thing as the haves and the have-nots. The divine nine, there's no family feud here because we all support the communities we hold dear. To our communities, to our families, to our friends, when it comes to service, let's make a deal to never stand still. Today, as we soar in unity, let's celebrate, let's commemorate, and let's collaborate. To the ladies of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, cheers to 115 years.
Okay, everyone, let's give all of our participants another round of applause for the hard work. At this time, we have a special video, a presentation, a tribute to our founders. This video shares a glimpse into the lives of our founders and the formative years of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. The production was produced for our 114th Joint Virtual Founders Day in January 2022. Please enjoy a modified version of the production.
Well, hello, and welcome to the Metro Alpha Kappa Alpha Museum. We have six exciting exhibits here, and they give you insight into the history of the first African-American Greek letter sorority for college-educated women. So are you ready to go on the tour? Come on, follow me. Follow me, let's take a glimpse into history. Come on and follow me, come follow me. In the the spring of 1907, on the campus of Howard University, Ethel Hedgman wanted to hear all that teacher Ethel Robinson had to share about the white sororities on the campus of Brown University. Ethel had a vision of enriching the social and educational experience of campus life for Negro college women. Teacher Ethel Robinson planted the seed in Sora Ethel's mind. Sora Ethel had dreams of doing some of the same things on the campus of Howard University, but she wanted to do more than social events. She wanted the female students to do more than study by themselves. She wanted to establish a sisterhood of like-minded, ambitious college women who had an interest in the survival and uplifting of the African American race. As Ethel's dream presses her into action, 8 young women were selected to move forward with the plans for a sorority. Ethel shared her vision for the sorority for Negro women on campus, and they were all filled with excitement. Ethel and the other 8 moved forward with their plans.
Are you all ready to make history?
Yes!
Follow me. Let's take a glimpse into history.
Oftentimes referred to as the guiding light, I was a phenomenal woman, a pioneer, a trailblazer, an organizer, and a planner. I was not lacking in creativity and trustworthiness. In essence, I was a GPS. I positioned and navigated the way for us to become an internationally recognized service organization. I am Sora Ethel Hedgman Lau, the guiding light.
Innovative, tenacious, resourceful. I am Anna Easter Brown, born on Easter Sunday and been doing the Lord's work ever since.
I am Beulah Elizabeth Burke, one of the founders of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, and was very active throughout my 67 years of membership.
I am Sora Lily E. Burke. I'm an attractive, intelligent, industrious, supportive, brilliant, and tenacious woman of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated.
Trailblazer, innovator, scribe, and memory keeper. I am Margaret Flagg Holmes, a book lover with a special interest in Latin, English, and history.
Although some described me as sweet-faced and soft-voiced, there was nothing sugary or mousy about me. Sora Lavinia Norman, yes, that's who I am.
I am Lucy Diggs Slow, and I'm known to be the first in everything I do.
Charming, studious, stylish, leader, trailblazer, and Southern Belle. I am Marie Wolfog Taylor.
I am Marjorie Hill. I wanted to live a purposeful life, and God chose me to be one of the founding historical 9 members of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority.
Follow me. Let's take a glimpse into history. The historical 9 searched hard to find other ladies who would pass the test. They found 7 sophomores who outshined the rest. Yes, they proved they were the best.
I am known for my dignity, poise, and grace. I am Sora Joanna Berry Shields.
Smart, pretty, and fine, not only on the outside, but from the inside. I am Sora Norma Elizabeth Board. Dedicated, relentless, tenacious, and passionate.
Hardworking, dedicated, committed, creative. I am Sora Ethel Jones Mowbray.
Educator, orator, perpetuator. I am Sora Sarah Meriwether Nutter, the Energizer Bunny, because I kept going and going for my sorority.
A true irreplaceably unique. A woman with the love of music in her heart, gifted with so many talents. Oh, where do I start? I am Alice P. Murray.
captivating and sophisticated. When I walked into a room, my style and grace commanded that everyone take notice. I am Sora Carey Snowden.
No one can magnetize a room like me. I am known as the smiling soror. Inspirational, strategic, creative, and resilient. I am Soror Harriet Josephine Terry.
Hold on. Wait, what? They did what? This is not gonna be good. Nelly Kwanda got an inside tip. Rumors floating all around. Our perpetuity was in jeopardy, but the incorporators shut it down.
I am Soror Nelly Kwanda. I am described as a part of the reckoning force, a pillar of Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority. I am nothing to play with when it comes to my beloved Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority.
Educator, administrator, incorporator. I am Soror Julia Evangeline Brooks.
Educator, campus leader, community leader, catalyst, visionary, incorporator. I am Nellie Pratt Russell, formerly known as Nellie Pratt.
Persistent, go-getter, dedicated. I am Minnie B. Smith.
Now you see, you've had a glimpse into history. You've had the chance to see how our history came to be. I'm glad you walked along with me. The 20 founding pearls are smiling from above, their work on earth complete. A legacy of excellence carries on in perpetuity.
Keep you.
for joining us on the tour today. We hope that you were amazed by the wonderful exhibits that explained the history of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated.
This amazing production was organized by Patricia Taylor of Rho Lambda Omega Chapter. Ms. Taylor, will you please stand at this time? Thank you so much for all of your hard work and dedication on this project. And we also want to thank those members who use their creativity to express gratitude to our founders. At this time, please enjoy another musical selection by our Joint Founders Day Choir. Then you will hear from attorney Missy Deese Page, our 26th Southeastern Regional Director, as she introduces our very special guest speaker for today.
Thank you.
said, and I have to come behind that. Order my steps, Lord, order my steps. Whew. My sisters and brothers, who's the lady who leads the southeastern region? A region of over 13,000 pink and green wearing, set it off strolling, soul stepping, service focused, and sisterhood based ladies. Well, it's none other than the woman with the initials of TMA, Dr. Tracy Morant Adams. What does TMA stand for? And who is this classy and sassy TMA? Well, wouldn't you know that her initials stand for the region she was elected to lead in March of 2022? The T is for Tennessee. The M stands for the great state of Mississippi, and the A is for Alabama. Professionally, Dr. Tracy Morant Adams is the Chief Community Development and Corporate Social Responsibility Officer for Renaissance Bank, serving as the Executive Strategist for the bank's Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Framework. Her humanitarian efforts have been celebrated by many, including the NAACP. In 2020, she was named one of Savoy's most influential Black executives in corporate America and by Profiles in Diversity Journal in 2022. Who's that lady? Let's see what those who know her best say about TMA. Sharon Ward, the regional treasurer and good friend of Dr. Adams, says TMA stands for tenacious, models, and authentic. In her words, she tenaciously models authentically. Her civic affiliations include serving on the Talladega College Board of Trustees, the Birmingham Kiwanis Board, the Women's Foundation of Alabama, Children's Hospital of Alabama, and the Lynx Incorporated. She serves as mentor to many, including her godchild, Trinity Odongo, who is also a member of the sorority. Who's that lady in the eyes of her goddaughter? She's thoughtful, motherly, and attentive. In Akaland, she's the charter member, and fourth president of Upsilon Eta Omega chapter in Fairfield, Alabama. She's a 35-year member and was initiated into Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated into the marvelous and magnificent Mu Mu chapter on the campus of the University of Montevallo. And who best to tell us who's that lady than her sorority sister and friend of 40-plus years, Consetta Hubbard Odongo, who says that TMA means that she's trustworthy, magnanimous, and affable. She has held numerous leadership roles at the local, regional, and national levels of our sisterhood. Most notably, she has served as the chairman of the International Membership Committee, where she spearheaded efforts to reactivate over 30,000 members during her tenure. Who's that lady? She's tenacious, magnanimous, and amusing, according to Ms. Malera Wright, Trailer Wright, who is with us today and who is the Southeastern Chief Administrative Officer. She is married to the first dude of the Southeastern region, Jeffrey J. Adams Sr., a life member of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated and bonus mother to J.J. Adams. Who's that lady, according to the love of her life, the first dude? She's thoughtful, multi-talented, and admirable. And she's the daughter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated life member, Callie W. Morant. Who's that lady? Who knows her best? Her mom, who is turning 84 years young today. And she says that TMA stands for tenacious, motivated, and accessible. Who's that lady? Now, y'all know that song, Who's That Lady? In the words of the Isley Brothers, she's Dr. Tracy Morant Adams, a beautiful and lovely lady. She's the regional director of the sophisticated Southeastern region. She's TMA, and in my words, she's thoughtful, mission-driven, and altruistic. She's also my friend of almost 30 years, whom I met as we worked together for Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you that lady, our Madam Regional Director, TMA herself, Dr. Tracy Lynn Morant Adams.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. And yes, you know I must love you, because today is Mama's birthday. She gonna be mad with y'all. To the presider, Ms. Wilson. Graduate chapter presidents, Dr. Sharon Williams, Dr. Chelsea Criddle, Mrs. Turkidia Martin, and Mrs. Gloria Jameson, our undergraduate leaders, Felicia Sheriff, Asia Johnson, and Skylar McKinnis, Founders Day committee members, the Founders Day committee chair ladies, international and regional appointees, other members of Alpha Kappa Alpha, our elected officials, community honorees, and guests. Good morning. Please allow me a moment to pause and pay very special recognition to two living legends of the Southeastern region. The 23rd Southeastern Regional Director, Dr. Juanita Sims Doty, and the 26th Southeastern Regional Director, Attorney Mitzi Despain. To follow the path of excellence inspired by these two remarkable leaders is truly an honor, and I am most grateful for their presence here with me this morning. Thank you, my dear sister and friend, Attorney Mitzi Despain, for the warm introduction. I truly am humbled by your kind words and by your kind deeds. You didn't tell me everything. You didn't tell me everything. Also, I must acknowledge the Chief Administrator for the Southeastern Region, Attorney Malira Traylor Wright, and Ms. Janet Crosby, a member of the region's protocol support team. Both are members of Upsilon Eta Omega chapter, and they traveled with me this weekend, and I thank them so very much for their support. And you got to thank them as well, because they encouraged me. Yes, they encouraged me about brevity on the drive down. So I'm going to try and not disappoint them. What a glorious occasion this is to pause and reflect upon the founding of Alpha Kappa Alpha and to salute chapter community leaders, servicemen, and first responders for their excellence in service. Your service is evidence that you are soaring to greater heights, that you are soaring in unity chapters, building on the very foundation of service, legacy, and sisterhood. Members of the Jackson Metro chapters and guests, it is indeed a great honor of mine to speak with you during this Founders Day celebration. Earlier this month, I had the distinct honor of representing the Southeastern region in our nation's capital as our international president and CEO, Ms. Danette Anthony Reed, led us into a fine recognition of our 115-year history. This gathering was in celebration, but it was also in service. We had the opportunity to pack over 6,000 power packs and healthcare kits to support DC community programming initiatives. And we also presented $500,000 toward an endowment fund to support women's history research conducted by Howard University. And I want to thank our Southeastern Regional Representative to the International Program Committee, Ms. Candy Simmons, for her work in leading that for our region. Thank you. Thank you so much. The warm welcome to DC was completed by President Joe Biden, who released a special video message recognizing Alpha Kappa Alpha's 115th year. He remarked on our reputation for employing culture and merit, and personally shared with us how women of Alpha Kappa Alpha have shaped his life over the years, especially our sorority sister, Vice President Kamala Harris. So today, yes, yes. So today's celebration only continues a global reflection of our founders with deep appreciation and deep reverence. As we celebrate the 115th year since the founding of our great sorority, we look with dignity upon our achievements. Alpha Kappa Alpha has shaped our local communities. Alpha Kappa Alpha has shaped our nation. And Alpha Kappa Alpha has shaped the globe for the better. We are a united sisterhood. I look with pride at how we have held true to our commitment of service to all mankind. And I look with pride to you, members and supporters of the Southeastern region, for playing a pivotal role in extending the caress of Alpha Kappa Alpha to families in Alabama, Tennessee, and of course, right here in the Magnolia State of Mississippi, so that they may feel our collective and compassionate embrace. As we reflect on the vision of our founders, I want to iterate how pioneering, how progressive, how powerful this vision was for such a time that they walked in. I think sometimes as we reflect on our heroes, we tend to imagine them as those seasoned leaders with decades worth of knowledge and foresight. Must we be reminded that the founders of Alpha Kappa Alpha were just young, college-aged women, much like the undergraduates of Tougaloo College's Gamma Omicron, Jackson State University's Gamma Rho, and Millsap College's Lambda Iota. Really, can you really imagine being one of only 1,000 African Americans enrolled in a higher education institution across the entire country? Can you imagine that? What a responsibility to bear at only 19, 20, 21 years of age. You see, our founders were just one generation removed from slavery, yet tasked with carrying the weight of our ancestors' wildest hopes, dreams, and faith into an era of newfound freedom. And in the very infancy of our freedom, nine juniors and seniors of Howard University bound their merit into what would become known around the globe as Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. Isn't that sweet? From the harvesting palms of our enslaved ancestors, our founders seized the baton to establish an enduring sisterhood and author a new, more hopeful page in our nation's history. My sisters, what a mighty testament of their village, and what an opportunity we have to carry this legacy to even greater heights, unified together for the greater good. We have the privilege of being the first African American sorority founded in 1908, the first African American sorority incorporated in 1913, the first African American Divine Nine organization to establish a multi-million dollar charitable endowment, and the first African American organization to raise annually millions of dollars to benefit our beloved historically black colleges and universities. And you know, that is particularly critical for the Southeastern region that houses so many HBCUs, the most of any state in our country. There are 28 HBCUs in the great states of Tennessee, Mississippi, and Alabama. And one of Alabama's 15 HBCUs is my beloved alma mater, the Alabama State University. And many of you gathered here, I'm sure, this morning are proud Mississippi HBCU students and alums. And while this speaks to our longstanding commitment to educational advancement, our focus does not stop here. No, we have been united together at the forefront of several social justice causes. In the 1930s, during racial and civil unrest, we became the very first organization to pursue a life membership with the NAACP. With this partnership, Alpha Kappa Alpha created a congressional lobbying task force to enact legislation against racial inequities. That very same year, we traveled to the Delta of Mississippi to establish what is still regarded as one of the most successful black-centered public health initiatives in our country, and served a population who so desperately needed the support of women who looked like them. And we also established the Cleveland Job Corps to offer job training to communities who faced immense economic hardship due to discrimination and disenfranchisement. Throughout our 115-year history, we have been united in our mission. And these examples are just one of the thousands of ways Alpha Kappa Alpha has cemented an unparalleled legacy of service. Yet, I caution my dear sisters, while we have the privilege of being the first of many, we also have the responsibility to not ever be the last. We must continue to be the example, set the standard, stay united, and stride in our path as the leaders of today and tomorrow, because what we do inspires and invites others to join, and it builds on the foundation of our service, our legacy, and our sisterhood. So what must we do to preserve this precious footprint of service and sisterhood? What must we do to remain soaring in unity? We must continue the same vine of perpetuity by being the visionaries of our chapters and communities, and by inspiring new ways to reach our mission through what I believe is the power of us. To soar in unity, we must transform our communities with strategic programming. We have been guided by 31 international presidents since Nellie M. Quander. With each successive administration, Alpha Kappa Alpha women continue to build on the legacy of our founders, expanding our reach and increasing our impact on local and global society. Through the years, we have each worked they have each worked to institute strategic social action initiatives and social service programs that transform communities. Under the current leadership of President Reed, we are soaring to greater heights of service and sisterhood. As we remain true to the cornerstones of our sorority, we are galvanizing more than 120,000 active members through 5 strategic program initiatives. Alpha Kappa Alpha is committed to empowering our families, building our economic wealth, enhancing our environment, advocating for social justice, and uplifting our local community. That's a very ambitious agenda, but we are united in our power, and we have never, ever, ever been daunted by a challenge. We have only been known to approach the needs of our communities head on, equipped with boundless hope and trust in our resilience. This agenda is only accomplished with the power of the Southeastern region. We are mighty in numbers, with more than 116 undergraduate and graduate chapters and more than 14,000 active members who are dedicated to the mission of our illustrious organization. Sustaining our local impact is imperative to our legacy. To soar in unity, we must magnify our local impact with chapter resilience. Today provides us the opportunity to thank our founders and also applaud the charter members of Jackson Metro Chapters for ensuring that Alpha Kappa Alpha's realized vision would reach the city of Jackson, Mississippi, and surrounding communities. We are grateful that in 1934, 6 women from Tougaloo College united to charter Beta Delta Omega. We celebrate that in 1988, 32 women united to charter Rho Lambda Omega. We have reverence for the 19 women in 1998 who united to charter Upsilon Upsilon Omega. And we applaud the 23 women who united in 2015 to charter Omega Beta Omega. Many of you are here in this room today. Now, these 4 powerful chapters, in partnership with 3 equally powerful undergraduate chapters, have taken today as an opportunity to collect items that will provide assistance and dignity to vulnerable populations experiencing homelessness. And their commitment, your commitment, it doesn't stop there. You each chapter has unique signature programs offering extensive community outreach because you know what your communities need most. And I thank you for your commitment of that. This was certainly evidenced by how quickly you organized into action to distribute critical resources during the Jackson water infrastructure crisis, and thus built a strategic coalition of local community partners to ensure that your most vulnerable citizens, neighbors, children, students, the elderly would not be overlooked in the midst of that crisis. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the power of our collective, unified impact. That is what happens when we will bound our merit and commit ourselves to social change. Alpha Kappa Alpha is unafraid to take the uncharted path. But like I said, though we pride ourselves in being the first, we are here to make a lasting change, and we must never, never, ever, ever be the last. We cannot and should not do this work on our own. We were founded to create lasting bonds with our community. So to soar in unity, we must accelerate our influence through partnerships. Look around the room. Just look around the room. We are surrounded by many capable hands and feet for service. Some of you in this room are members, many of you in this room, like me, members of the Divine Nine and National Panhellenic Council. Some are clergy members and members of nearby churches. Some are leaders of great institutions, businesses, healthcare, great organizations. We are all connected by a hope to see the city of Jackson, Mississippi, as a place where families have an abundance of opportunity and an abundance of resources to flourish. We are called, truly, we are called to the responsibility of addressing the social and moral issues that really define the frailty of life. With the power of us, the possibilities are boundless. If we combine our collective influences to better the world around us, I guarantee you, as my daddy used to say, that we can shift the status quo for communities. I join you today in reflecting on how our partnerships, not only throughout Jackson, but throughout the entire nation, can continue to carry us to a better tomorrow. We cannot wait. We cannot wait for anyone else to do the work. We must do the work because we are the carriers of our service. We are the carriers of our legacy. We are the carriers of our sisterhood. Sisters and friends, today we do pay homage to the vision, courage, and tenacity of purpose of the extraordinary founders of Alpha Kappa Alpha, those who answered the call to create the first organization for Black college women whose mission would not simply endure, but the mission would thrive for 115 years and counting, and thrive with glory. We remind ourselves of why it is so critical to preserving the same unyielding passion to deepen this legacy in our chapters, in our communities, in our nation, and I submit to you, throughout the entire world. Why us? And why now? Because we're ready. We're ready, we're willing, and we're able to be the resource our world so desperately needs, the resource Jackson, Mississippi is begging for, the change makers that Ethel inspired. And so, to my sisters, thank you. Thank you, Metro Jackson chapters, for your dedication in building upon a 115-year foundation of service and sisterhood. Our extraordinary founders, brilliant, beautiful women of Alpha Kappa Alpha, would have expected nothing less. Let us continue to work together so that we can realize the power of us and soar in unity. May God bless and keep you is my prayer, and may He continue to bless our beloved Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. We salute you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Adams, for those wonderful words, words that empowered us to soar. Now we have a special recognition. Also,
after a special recognition, if there are any other chapters who would like to make a presentation, please do so after Lauren.
To our local chapter presidents, the Southeastern Regional Director, and guests, good morning. My name is Lauren Temple, and I am a member of the Gamero Chapter at Jackson State University. Our Regional Director gave an inspiring message that's applicable to our journey. Let us please applaud her again. Dr. Adams, will you please join me at the podium? On behalf of the chapters in the Metro Jackson area, we would like to thank you for being here with us during the Joint Founders Day celebration. We are ready to soar with the power of us. As a token of our appreciation, please accept this contribution to the EAF scholarship named in your honor.
Oh, thank you.
We also want to provide you with a personal token of appreciation for all that you do for us. Please enjoy it. Again, on behalf of the Metro Joint Chapters, we love you and we thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. You know what I say, you didn't have to do it, but I sure am glad you did.
Thank you.
I ask for a special point of privilege and ask the ladies of Rolando Omega Chapter to please stand as we present our gift to our Southeastern Regional Director. Dr. Adams, the ladies of Rolando Omega Chapter, thank you for all your work and all of your support for the chapters here in the Southeastern region. And we also thank you for being here with us today. So here's a token of our appreciation. Again, thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Now we will have a special recognition of the milestones, followed by community recognition. Community recognition photos will be taken, so please stay on stage until after those photos are taken.
To the local chapter's president, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guests, good morning. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated is comprised of many graduate and undergraduate chapters throughout the United States and international. Within Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, we have levels of distinctive membership, starting with diamond membership. These are members with 75 years of service. Pearl members are members with 65 years of service. Golden members have 50 years of service. And silver members have 25 years of service. As I call your name, those celebrating these milestones in 2023, please stand as we join you in celebrating your milestones. Starting with the Silver Beta Delta Omega Chapter, we have Neil Robinson, Latanya Moore, Pamela Simon, Tanya F. Adams, Takeda L. Thompson, Thomas, Kimberly Campbell, Patricia Daniels. Thank you. Starting with the Civil for Rolanda Omega chapter, we have Sally Bond. Thank you. Civil for Upsilon Omega chapter, Jennifer Baker. Ursula Davis. Angela Reynolds. Thank you. Civil for Omega Beta Omega chapter, Tamika Curtis Holloway. Melinda Rankins. Kianka Stringfellow. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated also recognizes milestones for chapters. We have two graduate chapters celebrating milestones this year in the Jackson metro area. Rolanda Omega Chapter, chartered in 1988, is celebrating 35 years of service in the Jackson community. Will the members please stand and we join you in celebrating your 35 years. Of outstanding service. Upsilon Omega Chapter, chartered in 1998, is celebrating 25 years in the Canton community area. Will the members of Upsilon Omega please stand? Thank you and congratulations on your 25 years of outstanding service. Thank you all.
Greetings to our local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guests. Good morning. I am Teresa Burrell Shoto, Upsilon Omega. At this time, I will be presenting Community Service Recognition Awards. The Metro Jackson, Mississippi area chapters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated would like to recognize three organizations in our local service areas that are dedicated to providing services, helping others, and making a difference in the lives of so many individuals and families. To the countless other individuals, businesses, and organizations that are also committed to serving and helping others, we thank you with the highest level of gratitude. Your service does not go unnoticed. These recognized organizations represents and exemplifies our motto, service to all mankind. Providing this official recognition also supports our program initiative, uplifting our local community. First, we recognize the Institute for the Advancement of Minority Health. The Institute was established in 2019 to help reduce health disparities among disadvantaged and underserved minority populations in Mississippi. Through community-based partnerships that utilize the health equity framework and culturally appropriate solutions, the Institute's vision is to improve health outcomes in disadvantaged communities in Mississippi. Accepting this award on behalf of the Institute is Chief Executive Officer Dr. Sandra Carr Melvin. It reads, Community Recognition Award presented to Institute for the Advancement of Minority Health in recognition of service to our community. Metro Jackson, Mississippi Chapters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, January 28, 2023. Dr. Melvin. Next, we recognize Mississippi Votes. Mississippi Votes is a civic engagement organization dedicated to creating a livable, sustainable, and welcoming state for people and their futures. The organization trusts, values, and adheres to the leadership of its young, enthusiastic engagement professionals to invest in the forward progressions of Mississippians, regardless of cultural, gender, or racial lines. Mississippi Votes assists voter registration, voting rights, community engagement and education, collaboration, empowerment, and innovation. Accepting this award on behalf of Mississippi Votes is Community Engagement Manager, Mr. Karanja Matori. Reads, Community Recognition Award presented to Mississippi Votes in recognition of service to our community. Metro Jackson, Mississippi Chapters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, January 28, 2023. Finally, we recognize Our Daily Bread Ministries. Our Daily Bread is a nonprofit organization and ministry that provides free meals to low-income families, senior citizens, disabled, and homeless individuals in the Madison County, Mississippi area. The ministry delivers meals to homebound residents who challenges or is unable to otherwise access community services. They also prepare and serve daily hot meals to residents that come in to the facility. The organization helps bring awareness to healthy eating and aid in hunger relief in our local communities through God, through good works and good deeds. So accepting this award on behalf of Our Daily Bread Ministries is Ms. Vicki Smith. Thank you. Okay, it reads, Community Recognition Award presented to Our Daily Bread Ministries in recognition of service to our community. Metro Jackson, Mississippi Chapters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, January 28, 2023.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Give our honorees another round of applause. Next, we will recognize our elected officials, servicemen and women, first responders, followed by acknowledgments and closing remarks, and then we will recognize our fellow Greek organizations and hear the benediction.
Greetings to the local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and guests. Good morning. I am Angela Wright from Beta Delta Omega. Our founders were trailblazers, service women, visionaries, protectors, and contributors to this society. Their impact made a difference in the lives of others. As part of this joint Founders Day, the ladies of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated would like to recognize our noble men and women who exemplifies the traits of our founders and who have gone over and beyond the call of duty and extend their lives in service to others. It is there any elected officials in the room, please stand. Those would be judicial and executive leadership. We thank you for your commitment to assisting with making those tough decisions to better the lives of others. If there are any service men and women in the room, please stand. Those who serve in our country, armed forces, law enforcement, we thank you. We thank you to your service, giving selflessly of yourself to this country and for the countless hours of protection from foreign domestic terrorism. Thank you. If there are any first responders, medical providers in the room, please stand. Those who are medical and mental health services are serves as first responders in any way. We thank you. We thank you for your continued commitment to those unselfish time to care for others when it seems as though there is no one to care for you. Thank you for taking this global pandemic on with courage and grace to help us make it through. Thank you again. If there are any persons who assisted the city of Jackson with the water crisis, those who held water drives, delivered water, or participated in any way to alleviate the water situation, please stand. Thank you for for your commitment to assisting the fellow citizens in Jackson and surrounding areas to ensure all persons have access to clean drinking water. To all, please know that our contributions and sacrifices, your contributions and sacrifices are appreciated, and we are eternally grateful. Again, we salute you. Also know that the ladies of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated are here to encourage you to continue. And we are also here to partner to make our area a better place for all. We are here to provide service to all mankind. Thank you and have a great morning.
Good morning to the local chapter presidents, our Southeastern Regional Director, and our guests. There are many people who worked selflessly to make sure that this program was successful in honoring our founders, and we are grateful and blessed this morning. We would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to the 601 Live Band for providing beautiful music. Nikki's Catering Services for the delicious food for our reception. Jay Johnson, the photographer, for capturing our memories. The Joint Founders Day Steering Committee members and all members of the subcommittees for numerous meetings and collaborations. All of our program participants, thank you. We would like to extend a very special thank you to Pastor Joe May and his congregation here at Anderson United Methodist Church for allowing us use of this beautiful church and access for numerous rehearsals and planning meetings. Thank you, Rosa Wilson, for chairing the Joint Founders Day Committee, and thank you to all the chapter presidents for your hard work and leadership. We would also like to acknowledge all of the members of the graduate and undergraduate chapters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated who are represented here today. You have worked together seamlessly and you are appreciated. Most importantly, thank you to all of our guests for your presence here today and for your donations of non-perishable food, warm wraps, and toiletry items for the homeless community. From all of us to you, thank you.
to the local chapter presidents, the Southeastern Regional Director, and guests. What an awesome time we've had as we've reflected upon the life and the legacy of our beloved founders and all that God has allowed. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this day, a time to come together and reflect upon your good works. We ask right now, Lord, that you continue to instill in us true discipleship as we strive to be servants for the uplifting of your kingdom. May the strength of God sustain us. May the power of God preserve us. May the hands of God protect us. And may the way of God direct us so that the love of God will be with us this day and forevermore. Lord, we ask that you bless the food and the hands that prepared it, and that the food serves as nourishment for our bodies. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much for your time this morning. I hope you enjoyed our program. It has been a pleasure to serve as your program guide. At this time, we will have a reception. The reception is upstairs in the fellowship hall. The ushers will be able to guide you there. Thank you again so much for joining us.